Final group that's not on your page there, we are fortunate to have four student teachers this semester. We're sitting around with a prompt to bring coffee nowadays. I'd like to recognize them. They're here in backstage everywhere else. Leon Zamanovich. Ain't about saying that name right there. He's from TCU. He's here. He was backstage rolling up Wayne. Thank you. Give him a round of applause. From Arizona State University, Mr. Davis Smith. UTA, Long Wind. Also back here. Jacob Collins. We're very fortunate. These guys are hard workers and be great future music educators. Let's move ahead in our program. The piece that we're going to open with the symphonic band is, you're going to love this composition, Rippling Watercolors by Ryan Bondages. Welcome to the stage, the Keller High School Symphonic Band, Mr. Ryan Heath.
Thank you. give them a second to change here. The next piece is a movement from a much bigger work that we'll be spending time on this spring and playing several movements of Enigma Variations. Edward Elgar, the composer, took her Pomp and Circumstance at graduation, the same guy, much better piece. This is probably the most well-known movement. He wrote 14 variations on a theme, and this is the ninth variation that we're going to perform from the variations. That is not easy, and they're off to a really good start on that. We can progress the piece as well as the other things we're doing. Before we play our final piece, there are quite a few students in this ensemble that we recognize. They all participated in the all-region, all-state process. At this time, if you've earned a chair, a ninth grade chair, or a 6A high school region band chair, would you please stand so that we can recognize you? This next part is pretty cool. So as the process goes, you audition for region. If you're one of the very top few chairs at region band, and keep in mind it's all the students from Keller High School, from our sister schools in the district. It's also all of the 5A schools in our region, some of the other 6A schools. So each school will be a first-year flute player, a first-year clarinet player, a second chair, so on and so forth. And so for this next recognition, this is a pretty big deal. If you earned an area chair, would you please stand so we can recognize you? And then you get to area. It's the very best students from the very best high schools. Our area, it is the hardest area in the state. Students from the Plano schools, the Frisco schools, the Coppell area, the Hershey-Bedford area, Birdville ISD. We're talking about the best band programs in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. It is virtually impossible to make All-State. The odds are astronomical. And every year the percentage fluctuates anywhere from, if you're an All-State musician, you're in the top 2% to like the top 0.5% or 0.3%. It's almost unheard of to make All-State as a ninth grader. But I want to stand up. That's about 10 seconds longer than I'm a wanted recognition for. We're super proud of her. You'll get to meet our other All-State musicians. They're going to head down to San Antonio next week. They've got one more audition where they're placed into any of the, four different All-State ensembles they're eligible for. And so we're really excited for all of them. And super proud of Anna, the hard work that she's put in. And of course, she's got three more chances to do this. Our last piece, American Tweed, is a really fun march. Henry Fillmore, hope you enjoy it. Thank you. for our last part of the concert. Just a few more reminders. Dave, you mentioned this earlier. It takes just an incredible amount of volunteer work and time to make all of this happen, certainly all of the amazing things that we're going to do next fall. If you are at all able or interested in being part of the Booster Club, whether it's in an executive position, helping with fundraiser, even just bringing water on and off on a Saturday during the fall, we encourage you to please go visit the Booster Table out in the lobby. Every single hour of your time that you're able to give, it's 1 or 100. It goes such a long way in helping these amazing students be successful. Without further ado, please welcome to the stage the Keller High School Wind Ensemble, Mark Yeager.
Thank you.
Here we go. So it's technology, isn't it? This time of year, when we have this concert, I always try to find things that are not just UIL pieces of music. And so we try to expose the students to several things. I think you're going to really love these next pieces here. This first one is a brass choir piece. It has percussion accompaniment at different times, a different part here. But this is a chorale movement. And it's actually a movement of a much bigger piece. Did I see Scott Wayne in the audience a while ago? Okay. First of all, we played one piece earlier, that the Simone band played. That was a Keller High School marching band piece one time. Let's see if Scott knows its history. Scott, when did we play that in the marching band?
I don't remember, but I do know the one coming up.
Yes, he does. This one right here, we played many years ago in marching field. Remember what year it was? 1999 is the right answer right there. He can say that because he's that long of a band parent right here. Isn't that kind of crazy here? We go way back. And he's exactly right. This is a great piece of music. It's been used in different areas, but this is the third movement of Philip Sparks' dance movements. It's entitled Lento. You're going to love it. This is a brass chorale. Welcome to the stage here, the brass choir, percussion ensemble from Keller High School Wind Ensemble. Every year, we're able to find these really cool brass fanfares and pieces like what you just heard right then. I have a lot of sad faces in the woodwind section. And we were at the National Concert Band Festival last year with the Indian Springs Wind Ensemble, and there were different groups that are performing. One of them was featured in this really woodwind ensemble piece. I'm like, I think that will work pretty well for us. And of course, we've had it. It's been a joy to work on it. This is a chance to show off definitely the musicality of all these musicians here. Do I have any Harry Potter fans out in the audience? The squeal is a dead giveaway right there. This piece is, of course, the music film score was written by John Williams. Okay, Dwayne Davis will back log up today. It is his birthday. He's 86 years old. So, happy birthday, Dwayne Davis. What better way to celebrate than playing Nimbus 2000 from Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone? Groups to go out and support, so definitely check out the website, and we're so proud of all of the students and all their successes. Again, just continue, if you can be involved in the booster program, especially if you feel like, hey, I'd love to be an officer, contribute, definitely talk with Ms. Galassini out in the lobby. And then again, on the advertisements that are in there with the casino night, of course, the golf tournament, and it can be a committee of people. It doesn't have to see that's pretty overwhelming for me. It can be two or three people that say, I can only do this much, and we can piece it together. So definitely, whatever you feel like you can contribute with the team effort, we will be paying. We'll definitely have some people that'll be here that'll help us out. Tell your friends and coworkers about any opportunity we have to go out and support them, for sure. Mr. Heath alluded to this earlier with the students that did qualify for all of our all-region successes. We want to definitely recognize the students on the stage. Qualify for the all-region band. Stand and be recognized. Let's give these guys a round of applause. Just give you the opportunity to audition again for the second round of the All-State process, and that's the area level. You live again just the different schools that we compete against, and we're so proud of them that the area candidates. If you're an area candidate on stage, just have you stand to be recognized that you made area. I call their names here. We're so proud of everyone, and this will be quite an experience for everyone involved here. On trumpet, Mr. Ryan Delisle. Tenor trombone, Mr. Ethan Musselman. Chris Robbins. When you don't see behind the scenes, they're having to prepare, what was the trumpet one? 37 excerpts? They're having to prepare all different pieces of music that you go audition on. You have that chosen about 9 or 10. And I was asking someone, I was like, hey, how many hours a day are you playing or more? Basically, just working. It's like, oh, four hours a day. So they're working really, really hard. They're going to be have this experience of their life when we go in audition and get to perform with the All-State ensembles in San Antonio. So we're really proud of these guys. We're going to conclude our portion of the program, the Procession of the Nobles. It's actually a great piece of music that it's been around forever. It really pushes us technically. Students, when we're done, the way we'll work logistically is, of course, we need you to go. Wind ensemble on stage, you're going to be in charge of all the stands. You're just going to go straight out that door. Okay? And then all of the symphonic band members are in charge of all the chairs. And then I believe C1 and C2, is that correct? Are going to be doing risers. Just C1. C1 will be in charge of helping get the risers. They have a short straw on that, though. Okay? Percussion, you're going to go out that door when we're finished, and we're going to go this direction. Okay? By Rimsky-Korsakov, Procession of the Nobles.